and use and care instructions before beginning.
Hi, I'm Pat Clark from Lifting Gear Hire Corporation, and today we're discussing troubleshooting ideas regarding our air-operated chain hoists. These air-operated hoists are one of our most popular items, so we're going to start with the basics first. For openers, all of our hoists operate off of 85 PSI, but vary in the flow or CFM that they require. Also, we want to make sure that the hoist is being properly lubricated. We offer two different control types for our air-operated chain hoist. The first is the rope control, and the second is the air control pendant. However, our customers do work in very harsh environments, and the dust tends to cause havoc on these. So we're going to highly recommend using the rope control. That's what we're going to illustrate with today. The installation of the rope control is very simple. On the hoist, it has a rocker arm with holes in either end. Just want to make a couple nice knots, make sure it's nice and taut and secure. This next step is the most crucial. The majority of our calls regarding our air-operated hoist can be alleviated just simply by installing this device. This is an inline oiler and dirt stopper. This is the last item we want installed on the hoist before the hose. Assuming that you've confirmed that you have the proper air requirements in order to power the hoist, the next step will be hook up the airline to the hoist itself. Before doing so, whether or not you're using plant air or auxiliary air, it's important to blow the line out. We want to make sure that we clear the line of any debris or soot so it is not going into our hoist itself. Attach the couplings, and lastly, I want to make sure these couplings are secure by using some cotter pins. Depending on the frequency or use of the hoist, it's likely you're going to have to fill up the reservoir with a pacemaker oil. Simply remove the cap, pour the oil in until it reaches the top of the adjustment screw. You can also see the same level by a viewing window on the side of the oiler. Once you've reached halfway, it's properly filled. Over time, the dirt stopper may also need to be cleaned. Simply grab a pipe wrench, loosen the end fitting with a set of needle nose pliers, grab the screen on the interior, open it up, and spray it down clean with compressed air. It's also a good idea to wash this with a mild detergent, rinse it, roll it back up, and repeat the process. If your hoist is not lifting properly, it could be due to a couple of reasons. First, the load that you're trying to lift might be more than the rated capacity of the hoist. Also, depending on where your hoist is hanging, you may not be able to see the limit switches. In this example, you may not be able to see that the upper limit switch has been engaged. Simply back off and try again. If the hoist is lifting but doing so slowly, we want to look for other culprits. Starting with a hose, we want to ensure it's the proper diameter to handle the required flow for the hoist itself. Again, we want to recheck the levels of oil and ensure that that dirt stopper is nice and clean. Also, recheck all of your couplings and connections. If that's not doing the trick, we want to remove the oiler and dirt stopper and replace it with an air flow meter. This will measure the PSI and CFM right at the source of the hoist. Before we replace our connections, we want to take an industrial lubricant such as a PB Blaster and spray it right inside that coupling. Then we can reattach our oiler, dirt stopper, and our connections and retry. If you have too much pressure and or CFM powering the hoist, the brakes might not work properly and you'll experience a drifting effect. A simple solution to that is to add an air regulator within the system. If that still doesn't solve it, call us immediately. I'd like to remind you of a few safety guidelines and tips. First, never use the chain and the hook as a sling. In addition, never point load the hook. It's engineered and designed to deform to prevent catastrophic failure. An excellent alternative is to use a piece of hardware such as a shackle, whereby the pin will rest nicely in the base of the hook. Also, if you do use one of our air-controlled pendants, you should blow it out frequently with compressed air. We've even had customers that have protected it with clear plastic bags. On our larger capacity hoist with the multi-chain blocks, you have to ensure that this does not capsize and flip through on itself. If it does, the chain will twist and not operate correctly. You may feel this is difficult to do, but it has happened. We hope that you've enjoyed watching this troubleshooting video and found it helpful. In our rental fleet, we offer capacities ranging from a half ton all the way up to 50 tons. For more questions regarding air hoists and other products that we rent, give us a call. As a reminder, the contents of this video were for informational purposes only. Please consult the manufacturer's guidelines and use and care instructions before beginning.